Hello and welcome to our Rome specials, our consistory specials here on Catholic SG Radio and of course our Archdiocese YouTube channel. Rome, indeed, this is exactly where we are. So we are counting down to the day when Cardinal-elect William Goh is created a cardinal by Pope Francis. And indeed, we are very lucky also to have with us Father Ignatius Yeo. And our father is also a professor of liturgy. And Father, I want to ask you, I understand that the ordinary public consistory for the creation of cardinals is actually a short rite, I should say.
Yes.
Could you walk us through that?
So we have a short rite today, but through the centuries of the consistory, the creation of cardinals developed a particularly rich ceremonial form. In previous centuries, the creation of cardinals took place in a secret consistory where the Pope would announce the new name of the cardinal, and immediately the consistory would then call upon all those who have been named who are residing in Rome, right? And they will be notified of their nomination through a small little ticket which is written by the Pope.
Wow.
Which in 1879 that prompted Cardinal Newman, Blessed Newman, who was residing in Rome, and he delivered this beautiful speech based on this little ticket called the Biglietto. No? The same day when the new name has been announced and they receive this ticket, the new cardinals will then come to the Apostolic Palace to receive the red beretta from the Holy Father.
Mm.
And should the cardinal be living outside of Rome and unable to come, he will receive the beretta from the Pope through a special delegate.
Ah.
Right? In such cases, he would then promise to come to Rome to receive directly from the Holy Father his red hat and his title in person.
Okay.
The subsequent public consistory would usually take place in St. Peter's Basilica.
Itself. Yeah.
But occasionally also in the Sistine Chapel, also further down there, the other way.
Right.
Or in the consistory hall of the Apostolic Palace. Among the most moving moments in the ceremony would be the mentioning of the new cardinal's act of obedience to the Holy Father and the imposition of the red hat or the galero. And of course also their prostration during the singing of the Te Deum, which is a thanksgiving hymn, with their heads completely covered with their hood. This was followed by a special rite of the apparitio oris, the opening of their mouth, because the Holy Father would instruct the new cardinals to be shrewd and cautious in their words, because they'll be princes of the church and be representatives of the Holy See.
Right.
And the ceremony will end right after the Pope had given them the sapphire ring, which and assigned each cardinal to a titular church in Rome.
Is that sapphire ring still?
No more. No more sapphire ring now. After the Second Vatican Council, everything has been much more simplified.
Right.
To be more modest. And speaking of the council, so then after the council, the rites of creation of a cardinal was simplified, but keeping the essential elements.
Ah.
And it's therefore it acquired also a much more modest, simplified version in comparison to the earlier centuries.
Right.
The intention was to give the consistory a celebratory form.
Right.
But at the same time, to avoid any element that might give the impression that a creation of a cardinal is like another sacrament of the church.
Okay.
Right. So that is the guiding principle that the church used in the reform of the creation of cardinals for the Second Vatican Council. So in the new rite, a distinction was no longer made between public and secret consistory.
Okay.
Okay. So the oath and now the imposition of a beretta instead of a big red hat, the galero, and the designation of the title church was retained. However, the conferral of the cardinal ring right after the council took place at the Holy Mass, where the Holy Father concelebrated with all the new cardinals and the day after the consistory and will impose the ring.
But that's now different.
Now that's different, yeah.
Right.
But Paul VI was the first to use that rite.
Ah, okay.
Nevertheless, then, as you said, then the consistory underwent further modifications,
right,
and which brings it more being true to proper form of a liturgy of the word rather than a sacrament or right. in the Holy Mass.
So there's no Eucharist at all for yes. this rite.
Just to avoid semblance of it being like a sacrament.
Or an ordination.
Yes, so an ordination, right. so to say. So, and Pope Benedict the 16th, in his homily in the public consistory of 24th November 2007, said, it is an event that always inspires special emotion, not only in those who are admitted to the College of Cardinals, but for all those throughout the Church are gladdened by this eloquent sign of Catholic unity. And so the ceremony structure stresses the value of the task of the cardinals, and which requires them to work in close collaboration with the successor of Peter, the Pope. It also invites then all of us, the people of God, to pray that their service as our brothers, right, may remain, that they may remain faithful to Christ, even if it need be, to the point of giving their lives and allowing themselves to lay down their lives for the sake of the gospel.
Hence their vestments being scarlet.
Scarlet red, yes. Right. The symbol of their blood, the blood of being a martyr.
Indeed.
Right. So in this regard, to emphasize these two aspects that must characterize this event, the new responsibility assumed by the cardinals are found within the context of prayer.
Right.
After a few variations made in the practices in all the most recent consistory, it was deemed appropriate to add a few small modifications, and Pope Benedict XVI then reformed it in 2012.
Right.
First of all, since it is not a true and proper liturgical celebration of a sacrament,
right.
the Holy Father dresses differently in the choir dress. Okay. But Pope Francis desires to just only put on a stole and a cope, right?
Okay.
Yeah, because it is in the context of a liturgy of the word.
Right.
Then at the beginning of the rite, he pauses for a moment at the silent prayer at the confessio. That is where it's above, just above the tomb of St. Peter in St. Peter's Basilica.
Mm.
For the two prayers at the beginning and the end of the rite, the texts of the prayers are taken from 1969 and comes from the Roman Eucharistic tradition. And these texts of the Mass on occasion of the anniversary of the Bishop of Rome and Episcopal ordination are taken from the Leoninian Sacramentary. These prayers speak explicitly of the powers entrusted to the Church, especially the powers entrusted to Peter, in which now the cardinals share in.
Wow, okay.
Whereas in the initial prayer, the people also pray directly for himself as the successor of the apostles, the Pope, to carry out his office well. And the concluding prayer, the Pope invokes God's blessings on all the new cardinals. The proclamation of the Word of God resumes a shorter form, like the rite of 1969. A single gospel passage is chosen. Other readings and psalms are omitted.
Right.
After which, the cardinalsial ring is conferred on the new cardinal together with the red beretta and the title of his Church of Rome. And it's all done during the consistory and no longer done at the first Mass of the new cardinals with the Pope. At the beginning of the first Mass with the Pope, with all the new cardinals, the first of the new cardinals will address a word of thanks to the Holy Father on behalf of all the new cardinals. In previous rite, this greeting took place at the beginning of the consistory, but now it's at the first Mass where they will be present with the Holy Father.
And that, if I may say, is going to be on the 30th of August.
For this consistory.
For this consistory. Yes. Then.
And the consistory is consequently a celebration, therefore, of thanksgiving to the Lord for the gift of new cardinals to the Church, and especially an important and suitable opportunity to reaffirm our unity in Christ and to renew our common desire to serve the Lord with total generosity and the giving of our lives.
It sounds very simple, but yet so beautiful.
Very profound.
Yeah, it's the symbolism and where it is celebrated at the tomb of St. Peter,
yes.
right? Which part of the rite, Father, would be one that really stands out for you?
So because it is a rightful creation of a cardinal, for me what stands out the most is the moment where the cardinal ring is placed on the cardinal and his beretta is given to him and his title is given to him, because that is the exact moment where he really becomes a cardinal of the Holy Roman Church.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now you are going to be the man,
the man.
Who is going to be actually really witnessing history before your eyes. Before any of this, actually. You are going to be the marker, so to speak, for His Eminence. Yes. as they process into the ceremony. Tell me, what would be going through your mind? Or, I mean, just imagine, I mean, being there is already such a gracious thing.
Yeah. You know, as the Bishop's Master of Ceremony, I'm truly, truly honored to be given this opportunity to be his priest attendant, not marker. I'm his
priest attendant, yes.
At the ceremony, because in liturgical protocol, a prelate is always accompanied by an attending priest. And well, for this consistory, I'm the attending priest to His Eminence, the Cardinal-elect, right? Just to see to his vestments and books and etc. Just to attend to him during the ceremony.
Right.
Well, as you know, as I said, Pope Benedict XVI said, the consistory is an event that inspires special emotion, not only in the person being made a cardinal, but also throughout the church. And so I'm also part of the church.
Absolutely.
And I say, all of us are excited. And I guess for myself, then being seated right behind the cardinal elect, facing the confessio, just above the tomb of St. Peter, which is the very heart of the Basilica, the very heart of our Catholic faith, the confessio or the chapel of the confession of Peter refers to his confession of faith, which led Peter to his martyrdom. So, and also, you know, for me, serving the bishop all these years and witnessing his tireless efforts in renewing, reinvigorating our church in Singapore with his vision, right? Putting in so much effort, blood, sweat and tears.
Really?
Yes. Amidst many joys also, he also had to endure, you know, heartaches, trials, tribulations, you know. And my heart really goes out to him. And thus it will be a very special moving moment to see our bishop, our shepherd, ascending the altar just above the confessio. It will be for me an act of faith on the part of our bishop and his resoluteness in making this confession of faith in the church that we love, and willingness to lay down his life for the church, the flock of Christ, which is also for all of us. It is an affirmation of Christ to our bishop and to us, his flock. And in that, we hear the resounding voice of Christ saying, "You have not chosen me, I have chosen you." John chapter 15, verse 16.
Absolutely.
And as the Holy Father places the red beretta upon the head of our bishop, as you know, he said it's a symbol of martyrdom, that for me too is an encouraging moment for our bishop and all of us, his flock, that we must fight this good fight, finish the race, keep the faith, be faithful even unto death, and the Lord will give us the crown of life.
Amen. Amen. That already, Father, I mean, just hearing you, I can just almost imagine that emotion that will be going through you.
I mean, even not there yet, and now just speaking about it.
Yeah, I mean, but you know, we are standing on hallowed ground. This is the church itself, truly the heart of the church, and you know, we are so blessed.
Really a grace moment.
Amen.
For him and for our church in Singapore.
Really. So our dear friends, whilst we wish that you could be here with us as well, you will not be alone. You will be able to watch the consistory, this public consistory of the creation of a cardinal, and see our Archbishop William Goh be created a cardinal, a prince of the Catholic Church, the universal global church.